sister's lips, and right away began the Ujjayi breathing. Breathe in through your nose. Toward your chest, pause and reverse directions. Back to center, take a side bend and a twist. So on your next breath in, reach your arms up overhead, come off to your left, reach up and across with your right arm. Back to center as you breathe in. As your side, stretching through your side. Back to center, reach both arms up overhead. Take your right hand to your left knee to twist. Back to center, reach both arms up overhead and twist in the opposite direction. All the way back to center, release your hands and make your way to a tabletop position. Let's continue to warm up the spine with some cats and some cows. So breathe in, drop your belly with the crown of your head and your tailbone. Breathe out to round. And again. Last time. Back to center, bring your knees wide, bring your toes to touch, hips to heels, or child's pose. Walk your hands forward, release your chest and your forehead down towards your mat. Close your eyes, feel the stretch of your hips and your low back, moving all of your attention to your root chakra. Begin to visualize a red glowing ball of light. And come back to your mantra. I am safe. I am here. Whatever that is for you. Take one more breath. Place your forearms down on the floor, and then you're going to just paddle your way forward. Pose. So you're going to start to bring your chest down toward the floor, extend your legs out behind you, feet flat to the floor, and then lift up as you open your chest and you reach up through the crown of your head. Take another breath here in Sphinx Pose. And tuck all 10 toes under and come up to forearm plank. one more time. So heels up to the right, through center, to the left, to the center, back behind you, stretching your calves and your Achilles. Lift your heels high, back to tabletop with knees hovering over the floor, and back to downward facing dog. Look toward your hands and walk your feet toward the front of your mat. Come into ragdoll pose. So drape your torso over both thighs. Take opposite hand to opposite elbow or rest your hands on the floor. Release all tension from your neck by letting your head just dangle down toward the floor. And again, you can find movement here if you like, swaying side to side. One more breath in ragdoll. Release your hands down toward your mat, and on your inhale, come up to monkey pose. So halfway lift, you can begin to straighten your legs, flatten your back, reach through the crown of your head. And then exhale, uttanasana, standing forward, fold. So this is focusing more on the length in the back. Your legs, your hamstrings. And then on your next breath in, come to a halfway lift again. Extend your arms straight out to the side, capital T, with your palms facing down. And then big breath in as you come all the way up to tall mountain pose. Connect the palms of your hands above your head, and then bring your hands to your heart. Connect your thumbs to your sternum. And then take a little peek down at your feet. And spread your toes so that each toe is connected to your mat. And then we're going to take a moment to close the eyes. Bring all of your attention to your feet. Feel your feet grounded on the earth. Start to rock your weight very slowly forward onto your toes and then back onto your heels. Feel your legs working to keep you balanced as you rock back and forth, connecting with your feet. And come back to a neutral position and start to rock side to side. So feel the outer edges and the arches of your feet as you rock side to side. And then take a circle in one direction. And then reverse directions. Come back to a neutral position. Release your arms down by your sides, palms face out for Tadasana, mountain pose. Mountain pose, continue to lift up through the crown of your head as you feel your feet firmly planted and grounded on the floor. Visualize a red ball of glowing light at your root chakra. Engage Muladhara Bandha. Come back to your mantra. I am grounded. I am here. On your next breath in, put your arms up overhead, and then draw your elbows down, open your chest, lift your chin, back to tall mountain, and then forward fold, come all the way down, hinging from your hips, inhale, halfway lift, exhale to fold, and again, halfway lift, breathe in, forward fold, breathe out, plant your hands, step back to high plank pose. Hold here as you breathe in. And then as you breathe out, lower all the way down onto your belly. Tops of your feet come flat to the floor. Inhale, peel your chest up off the floor for cobra pose. Lift your hands up off the floor. Draw your elbows back. Keep spacing. high plank, you can either be up off the floor or on the floor, and then press back to downward facing dog. Lift your right leg up, open your hip, and bend your leg. Take a circle of your ankle in one direction, or circle of your foot, and in the other direction. Level your hips and straighten your leg, and then bring your knee towards your nose, set your foot between your hands, take your back knee down onto your mat, and lift your arms up overhead. Bring your hands to Arrow Mudra, interlace your fingers, release your index fingers, cross your thumbs, squeeze your biceps toward your ears, feel the stretch in the front of your left leg. Feel the lift of your fingertips up toward the ceiling. Take another breath here. And exhale, bring your hands back to your heart. And cross your left elbow over your right knee. As you press your palms together, twist more deeply into your spine. You can look up or back or down at the floor if you feel unbalanced. And then come back to center, release your hands, and take half splits pose. So begin to straighten through your right leg. You can stay here with your left hip over your left knee, or you can come all the way and sit onto your heel and forward fold over your right leg. Ardha Hanumanasana, half splits pose. Take another breath as you open and lengthen your hamstring, the back of your right leg. And then you can just crawl yourself forward back to a low lunge position. Tuck your back toes under, lift your knee up off of the floor, and step back to downward facing dog. Breathe in here. And out. Lift your left leg up, open your hip, and bend your leg. Circle your foot in one direction. Circle your foot in the other direction. Bring your left hip in line with your right. Straighten your left leg behind you. Bring your knee toward your nose as you round your spine, and then set your foot between your hands. Release your back knee onto the floor. Find Arrow Mudra. This time take the opposite cross of your thumbs. Bring your biceps by your ears. Feel the opening in your right hip flexor, the front of your right leg. Feel the reach of your fingertips up toward the ceiling. Breathe in here. Exhale, bring your hands towards your heart, prayer position, and twist right elbow to the outside of your left knee. As you press the palms of your hands into one another, deepen into your twist, bringing your thumbs closer to your sternum and your sternum closer to your thumbs. Unwind from your twist. Place your hands on the floor for half splits pose. Begin to straighten your left leg. And you can take this variation that I'm in right here, or you can sit all the way down onto your heel and fold over your left leg. Feel the stretch in the back of your left leg. And just crawl your way forward all the way back to a low lunge position. Tuck your back toes under, lift your knee, and step back to downward facing dog. Breathe in and out. We're going to do three rounds of sun salutations to create a little more heat in the body and begin to connect each breath with each movement. So look toward your hands, step back or float to the front of your mat. Breathe out as you fold over your legs. Inhale to rise up, tall mountain. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, high to low plank. You can step, walk, float your way back. Inhale. upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. That was round one. Breathe in. And out. Come to the front of your mat as you inhale. Forward fold. Exhale. Tall mountain. Forward fold. Halfway lift. Chakra breath. High to low plank. Upward dog. Downward dog. That was rounds two. Last round. Come to the front of your mat as you inhale. Fold as you exhale. Rise up. And fold. Halfway lift. Chakra breath. Upward facing dog. Exhale back to downward facing dog. Breathe in. And out. Look towards your hands. Step or float to Malasana. Bring both feet to the outside with both hands. Sink your hips down. Bring your hands to your heart. This is uncomfortable in your ankles. Your heels are not resting on the floor, but that is uncomfortable. You can always place a prop underneath your heels. That could be a blanket or your folded up yoga mat. If your hips are really tight and that's uncomfortable, you can always sit on a block. Okay, you're still getting a nice hip stretch. So we're going to hold this pose. So find a place where you're obviously feeling a stretch, but that you can hold it and not be in pain. So if you want to close your eyes, engage Muladhara Bandha. Visualize a ball of red glowing light at the base of your spine and your root chakra. Reconnect to your mantra, your affirmation. Feel the groundedness and stability of this posture as it opens your hips, your low back. Last breath here. Now, release your hands down onto the floor and make your way, or just begin to straighten your legs. So make your way to a gentle wide-legged fold and just kind of sway side to side. A gentle way to come out of that very intense hip opener. And now from this position, heel toe your feet to hip distance or to touch. We're going to take chair pose next. So whatever position works for your low back, take that position. So sit your hips low, reach your arms up for Utkatasana. So this pose builds a lot of heat in the legs, so building strength in the quadriceps, building strength in the glutes, shoulders, the chest, opening and lifting as you sit lower. your heels back down on your mat, and then inhale, come up to standing. Oh, exhale, cactus your arms. Inhale, palm tree pose. So lift your arms up, and then begin to lift your heels at the same time. So balancing here. We're trying to balance. Feel all the little micro movements in your toes and your feet to hold you. And then exhale, release heels all the way to forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale to fold. Step back, high plank. Moving lower chakra on your back to downward facing dog. And on your next breath in, lift your right leg up and step forward to little lunge. Keep your back heel lifted up off of the floor and make your way to crescent lunge. Take a deep breath in here, and then as you breathe out, lower your knee down toward the floor. Okay, press it up and lower. Last time and lower. Come right back to crescent lunge. And then you're going to bring your left hand forward and your right arm back to twist. Take revolve reverse warrior. So slide your left hand, I'm sorry, right hand at your left leg and reach your left arm up and back. And you're going to, from here, rotate your way to prayer squat. So you're just going to circle your arm, bring your hands to your heart as you open up to the side. So take a deep breath in, settle in to your prayer squat, so sink low. Close your eyes if you feel balanced. Visualize the red light at the base of your spine, engage Mula Dharmada. Feel the strength and fire building in your legs. And now let's connect breath to movement. Bring your arms up overhead. Reach up, connect the palms of your hands, and then exhale, squat. Inhale, lift, squat. Lift. Chakra. Breathe in, lift up. Now this time, exhale, goddess pose. Bring your arms to goal pose, palms face in. Sink down into your squat. And then repeat your mantra, either in your head or out loud here as you hold this strong, powerful, grounded posture. Breathe in, star. Breathe out. Prayer squat and bring your hands down onto your knees. Go ahead and rotate toward the front of your mat, little twist in your spine to sink deeper into your squat, stretching your inner thighs. Come back to center, switch sides. Come back to center, bring your hands back to your heart, stand up, five-pointed star, and then exhale, warrior two. Face the front of your mat. Hold here for just one full breath. Breathe in and out. Breathe in, reverse warrior. Breathe out, side angle pose. You can place your hand on a block, elbow on your knee, hand reaching toward the floor. Reach up with your left hand. Reach forward with your left arm. Feel the stretch along the length of the left side of your body. Reverse triangle. Straighten your right leg. Reach up and back. Triangle pose. This time direction of straight. Don't block it out. Leave a tiny soft bend there. And then as you exhale, both hands to the earth, back heel lifts up. And step back, high plank, chaturanga, upward dog, and downward facing dog. Breathe in, lift your left leg up, step forward, low lunge. Bring your arms up overhead. Dip your knee down toward the earth, bringing it to hover, finding a stretch in your toes, bottom of your foot, and strengthening your legs. So lift, lower. Lift up, straighten your leg, but keep your heel lifted up off the floor, and then twist. Right arm forward, left arm back. Revolve, reverse warrior, slide your left arm down your right leg. Reach up and back with your right arm, and then spin, prayer squat. Hands to your heart. This time, lift your right heel up off the mat. Feel the strength building in your calf muscle. Feel the flexibility building in your toes and the bottom of your foot. Release. Switch sides. Release. Lift both heels up off of your mat. Release. Lift up, five-pointed star. Warrior two, face the front of your mat. Take one breath. Reverse warrior, stretch back, side angle pose, reach your right arm up, maybe look up, if you need more assistance with your balance, look down, reach your right arm forward, feel the stretch along the right side of your body. Reverse triangle, straighten your front leg, slide your right hand down your right leg, stretch back, opening your left side, triangle pose, reaching forward with your left hand, placing it on the block or the floor or your shin with very little weight, reach your right arm up, breathe in, exhale, low lunge, step back, high plank, and then two downward facing dog. Take a breath in and out. Bring your feet to touch. Lift both heels high and then bring your knees wide as you squat back and then straighten your legs. Squat back, straighten your legs. Froggy squats, just two more. Okay, now bring your knees straight forward to hover over your mat. So you're back in that tabletop position with your knees off of the mat. So a little bit of core work. So hold it for 3, 2, 1. Now place your knees on the floor and bring your hips back towards your heels for toes pose. Sit upright, once again, stacking head over shoulders over hips, so nice tall spine, resting your hands on your thighs, close your eyes, ramp up your breath in and out through your nose, if you need to, you can take open mouth, exhales, releasing heat. And your awareness to your root chakra, engaging Muladhara Bandha. with your feet flat to the floor. Sit your hips back towards your heels. If and only if you have healthy ankles, rock your knees up off of your mat. Just for a counter stretch for your shins, the fronts of your feet, the ankles. And then make your way back so your shins are on the floor. Now keep your shins where they are, knees touching, and then separate your feet for hero pose. Sit your hips between your heels. If you need to or want to, you can place a prop underneath your hips. Sit up tall here, or you can recline. Recline hero pose. So you can place your hands on your mat up in front of you, and then extend your right leg back so it's straight. Heel stays lifted off the floor, and then just rock forward, backward. Switch sides. Extend your left leg up behind you and rock forward and backward. And then extend both legs out behind you so you're in plank pose and press back to downward facing dog. From downward facing dog, you can walk your feet to the back of your mat. Clear and forward fold at the back of your mat. Take your right peace fingers, wrap them around your right big toe. Take your thumb and press it onto the top of your toenail. Take your left hand onto your left hip. Come to a standing position on your left leg as you bring your right foot up with you. Take it slow so that you can maintain your balance the entire way on your way up. Okay, now hold here for three more breaths or extend your leg for three more breaths. Bring your right foot to tree pose. Place your foot on your inner thigh or your calf or your ankle. Bring your hands to your heart. Find a place to gaze. Relax your face. Maybe experiment with closing your eyes. Even with just one foot on the floor, can you feel the stability in your foot and your leg? Can you feel your toes in contact with the ground? Can you visualize roots growing out underneath you into the ground, holding you firmly? Release your right foot to the floor. Give your legs a little bit of a shake if that's needed. Inhale your arms to tall mountain, reaching up overhead. Exhale to fold. Take your left peace fingers and wrap them around your left big toe. Take your thumb and place it your calf and your ankle. Bring your hands to your heart. Find a steady place to gaze or experiment with closing your eyes. Visualize a red glowing ball of light at the base of your spine. Bring to your mind your affirmation or your mantra, connecting with groundedness and all of the groundedness found in this pose. Slow, steady, dry breaths as we hold these stretches. with your foot. If you need to, bend your leg so that you can connect your forehead toward your knee, to your knee. Thank you. pose or your supported bridge pose coming down onto your back. But keep your left leg bent and cross your right ankle over your left knee for reclined pigeon pose. One last hip stretch. So lift your left foot up off the floor. Hold on to your thigh or your shin. Stay active in your feet, flexing your toes back. Your left foot to the floor, switch sides. Place your right foot on the floor, cross your left ankle over your right knee, lift your right foot up. Keep your feet active, hold on to the back of your thigh or your shin for reclined pigeon pose on the other side. Release your foot back to the floor, uncross your ankles, bring your feet to mat distance apart, and then rock your knees side to side, releasing your low back. You can take your arms up to goalpost or T position. Next time your knees come to the right, rest them down on the floor. If you'd like to deepen the twist, cross your right ankle over your left knee and gaze in the opposite direction of your knees. Come back through center and place your knees to the left. Then you can cross your right, your left ankle on your right knee if you'd like to, and gaze to the right. Hug your knees into your chest. Bring your forehead towards your knees. Find a nice tight squeeze, little ball here. And then release Shavasana. Arms rest alongside your body. Press your, or let your fingertips relax. Let your toes relax. Breathe in through your nose and hold it. Let it go through your mouth. Visualize a red ball. Spine. Connect it to the core.